Yes, students, let us see the working of priority encoder. If two or more inputs are activated simultaneously, the encoder has to decide which input needs to be considered. The one simple way to overcome this problem is to prioritize the level of the input. So, to overcome this problem, the priority encoder has been designed. Say, for example, in this particular case, here we have taken an example of a 4 to 2 encoder. We have got 4 inputs. If D0 is, if any one of them is active at a time, then the 4 to encoder shall be able to give the output. On the other hand, if 2 or more inputs or more than one input is active at the same time, then the encoder will not be able to give the appropriate output. So, what has been done is, to overcome this problem, the one with highest priority, with the highest number, will be given the highest priority, and the one with lower number will be given the lower priority. Say, for example, if D0 and D1 become active simultaneously, D1 will be given the highest priority compared to D0. Okay, so let us see how this works out in an 8 line to 3 line priority encoder. In 8 to 3 priority encoder, we have 8 inputs D0 to D7, and we have 3 outputs Q0, Q1 and Q2. Now, if more than one input is active, then let us assume that if let us D2, D3 and D5 are active at the same time, okay, then the question arises to which pin the priority should be given to. Okay, now if you consider D2, D3 and D5 students, D5 is of higher value, higher number compared to D2 and D3. Now, so in the normal encoder, this confusion exists and the encoder shall not be able to identify the input to which the priority has to be given to, or to develop the output according to the input to which the priority has to be given. But in case of this priority encoder, as I was telling you, this problem has overcome. Okay, so here what happens is D5 will be given the higher priority. Now, so the D5 pin will be made active low, if at all the priority encoder is an active low input circuit, and all the inputs below that will be made don't care terms, and similarly the inputs above this will be made logic high. Okay, so the output that will be generated will be in accordance with the input for which the priority has been given to. Okay, so this is the logic that takes place whenever more than one input becomes high simultaneously. Okay, so here is an example of 74LS148. 74LS147 and 148, they are all priority encoders. 147 is 10 to 4 priority encoder, whereas 148 is 8 to 3 priority encoder. So this is how the pinout diagram looks like. See here, we have the pins. Here we have 8 inputs, 0, 1, 0 to 7. Okay, we have an enable input. EI is the enable input. This is an input pin. And you can observe here, all these are active low inputs. Okay, we do have outputs A and B. They are all active low outputs. We have output pins GS and EO. They are active low output pins. Okay, so here is the data sheet of 74148. This is how the data sheet of 148 looks like. This is manufactured, this particular IC is manufactured by National Semiconductors. Okay, so this is the data sheet of that National Semiconductor. National Semiconductor is not the only manufacturer. There are a few more manufacturers who will be manufacturing this. But whosoever is the manufacturer, for 74LS148 or 74XX148, the pin diagram and many of the electrical features remain common. Okay, so this is the pin, this is the truth table for 148 students, and here is a list of electrical characteristics. Okay, so based on the truth table, this is the internal diagram that will be there in the integrated circuit. Okay, so coming back, okay, so this is the truth table of 148. This is what we had seen in the data sheet also. Now, if EI is high, if enable interrupt input is high, okay, this is an active low signal In the IC, when this becomes high, irrespective of the status on the input, your output A0, A1, A2 remain high. Okay, so and even your GS and EO also remain high. It means that we should not consider this input. Okay, and EA is high means none of the input, the circuit hasn't considered any of the inputs. On the other hand, when EA is low, only then the status on the input will be considered. Okay, now when EA is low, we can have two conditions, one with zero, one without zero. Okay, when EA is zero, when EA is zero, if all the inputs are high, even then the output will remain high. Okay, but the difference between this first row and the second row is, in the first row EO was high, whereas here EO is zero. Means we should not consider this output, right? Now, so this is the condition where EA is zero but all the inputs are non-zero. Okay, on the other hand, when EA is zero and if any one of the input is zero, then what will happen to the response? If one of the input is zero, then you are going to get the output which will be appropriate to the inputs. Okay, A0, A1, A2 will be high. You can see here GS is zero. Okay, so we need to consider the outputs only when GS is zero and EO is high. Okay, on the other hand, if GS is high and EO is low, the whatever is the output shall not be considered. Okay, now for this is when the D0 is enabled, when the input D0 is enabled. If input D1 is enabled, okay, so D1 is of higher priority compared to D0. So what will happen? D0 has been made don't care. D1 is active low and all the inputs above D1 have been made high. Means what? Whatever the situation you have on the other inputs, they will not be considered once D1 has been made low. Okay, and anything below D1 will not be considered. Okay, so this is the condition and you will be getting the output according to that. 110 will be the output that we have got. Okay, so this is the truth table and this is a pinned description for this 74148. Okay, so we have the inputs, right? And A1, A2, A0 are the outputs. GS will go low when EI is low and any input is low. Okay, that's what we could see from the truth table. If EI is low, okay, GS will go low when EA is low and any one of the input is low, GS will go low. The output need to be considered only when GS is low, not otherwise. Okay, and your E0 will go high when EA is low and if there is any one of the input is low, only then your EO will be going high. So whenever you are considering the output on this 8-to-line priority encoder, you just need to check what is the status of GS and E0. Okay, one of them will be able to give us the result. If GS is low, okay, and E0 is high, then whatever the output that we have got on the pins A0, A1, A2 are valid. Okay, otherwise it is not valid. Okay, now for this particular truth table, the logic circuit has been drawn by the manufacturer and this is the internal diagram of 74LS148. Okay, so we have the output pins E0, GS, A0, A1, A2. They are being derived by the inputs 0 to 7 and the input enable input pin. Okay, so this is about 8 to 9 priority encoder students. I'll be stopping at this point. Let us start with the next topic.